What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. And today, it's time to review Bon Jovi's Have a Nice Day, the 2005 album, an album that I was heavily anticipating. Well, I anticipate heavily every Bon Jovi album, but this was big. This was coming off of an experiment with This Love Feels Right, which wasn't really up my alley first time I heard it, but I mean, it grew on me a little bit, and it's a greatest hits type collection deal, kind of a weird thing that they did, and it's all good, but we need some rock and roll. Could Bon Jovi come back, give us something powerful, something strong, a great album, remind us that they still got it from their heyday of the 80s and 90s with Have a Nice Day? I believe they succeeded. I am a huge fan of this album. This is one of my favorites right here. Have a Nice Day. Awesome stuff. Almost beginning to end. Not too many low points. We're going to get into this one. A really fantastic job with Have a Nice Day. It absolutely rocks. And I love John Bon Jovi's vocals in this one. It's got an edge to it. Got a little bit of grittiness to it. Can't really explain it. But this album, it's just awesome. Really love this one. A killer album right here, and Have a Nice Day. And let's get into it song by song, starting with, of course, Have a Nice Day. Not surprisingly, guys, I absolutely love Have a Nice Day. It's a great song. It's a song that goes over great live. I love the guitar riff. I love that Richie can bust out the double neck guitar on this one, and it's just awesome. Great opening riff, and great how the drums go with it, and it is a very similar riff that I probably mentioned. I'm sure I did when I reviewed one of their newer albums in This House Is Not For Sale. You can hear that very similar, and it's almost like Have a Nice Day light. Well, Have a Nice Day is Have a Nice Day, okay? Pro, this is the one, and it is a great song, and it's got a killer chorus, and I love the lyrics. It's just a fantastic song. It doesn't absolutely blow me away, but as far as a first single, this is one of my favorites, because oftentimes first singles, they don't always do a great job. At least for my taste, a lot of the times their first singles from albums are not my favorite, or not even nearly my favorite on the album. This one is definitely one of my favorites on the album. It's not my favorite, but it is a great song. Love Have a Nice Day. Love the lead. Love everything about it. It's a fantastic song. I'm giving this one a 9.5. Next up is I Want to Be Loved, and this song also kicks ass. Great second song on the album, keeps the energy going, and a sick riff. I love that. Came up with something. You know, you can't just keep writing the same old type of stuff. Come up with something cool. Come up with something unique. Keep it fresh. And with that opening guitar riff, how it, you know, it's choppy. And then the way that the vocals go over that are just killer. And then, of course, an awesome chorus. And got to mention the talk box in that one. That's a feature in this song. And it's just something that I'll really miss since losing Richie to the band. Haven't heard a lot of talk box since then. But this song is absolutely awesome. I loved it. And when I first heard the song, obviously, I had already heard Have a Nice Day, because Have a Nice Day came out as a single about a month before the album dropped. But once the album dropped, this song was it. Like, okay, what do you got? And boom, I love it. Awesome. Giving it also a 9.5. You're caught between just who you are and who you wanna be. If you feel alone and lost and need a friend, remember every new beginning is some beginning's end. Welcome to Wherever You Are, and I heard that John Bon Jovi was really high on this song, wanted to release it as a single. He thought it was going to be this big hit. I never loved the song like that. Like, I wouldn't have recommended it to be even be a single. I mean, it's a nice song. I don't know. I thought a little bit on the nose with some of the lyrics. I didn't love it. Some of the lyrics almost cringe type level for me personally, and it's not that it's bad. And just it had some decent hooks and everything, and it's got some pretty acoustic guitar work. This song, for me, I just didn't think this was just had the it factor to be a big hit or even to be something I love. But I do like the song. I like Welcome to Wherever You Are, and it's nice. It's just not, I just don't love it. I think it's around a 7. I mean, that's just where I'm at with this song, and it never really grew on me any more than that. I mean, I heard it when first time. I was like, okay, maybe I'll start to like it more. Not a whole lot. It's still decent. I don't skip it. It's time to hear it. I hear it. But Welcome to Wherever You Are, never really, I thought, was anything as great as I think John wanted it to be. So I'm giving it a 7.
Take it with you when you go. Who says you can't go home? Who says you can't go home? There's only one place they call me one of their own. Just a hometown boy on a rolling stone. Who says you can't go?
So even though a little bit of a letdown here with Welcome to Wherever You Are, bounces right back with a great song, and Who Says You Can't Go Home, obviously a huge hit, and went up the country charts to number one, which led us to Lost Highway. That's a whole nother thing there, how you feel about that. But personally, I would have not preferred they went down the country route, but it is what it is. This song, though, not talking about the country version, which is all right, but I love the original version, the rock version of this song. It is awesome. I love the riff. I love Richie's guitar work in this one, and the solo, short, but he just nails it there. It's a great guitar solo and just a great song, and super lyrics, just awesome lyrics, fun to listen to. And there's a reason this song is a big hit. There's a reason that they still play this one live, and it goes over great live. It's a fantastic live song. I still haven't gotten to any 10s yet. We'll get to some, but this song, I don't think it's a 10, but it's really close. It's a great song, and I really love it, and I always enjoy it when it comes on. And got slightly old over the years, ever so slightly, get a little tired of it, especially because that goes on and on. It's all right, it's all right, it's all right, it's all right, it's all right if you stop saying it's all right. That aside, just teasing a little bit, that aside, it's a fantastic, it's an awesome song. I love Who Says You Can't Go Home, and I especially loved it when it first came out. I'm just saying, we've heard this song so much, and I would love to hear some of the other songs live as well. John, come on. But no, I'm also going to give this song a 9.5.
To breathe and to ride your own risk, mister. It might change the way you think. There's no dancers, there's no diamonds. No, this boy don't lip sync.
Last Man Standing is one of my favorites, and this song I first heard on the box set right here, 10 million, 100 million, whatever, 100,000 million, 100 million, I think it is, 100 million Bon Jovi fans can't be wrong. That particular version is different, and I thought that that version just fit the lyrics perfectly. It's a little more calm with the piano. Dun, dun. I'll play a little clip from that version right here so you can hear what I'm talking about.
Of a lifetime. The real thing. See those real life callous fingers wrapped around those guitar strings. Kiss the lips.
I felt like that version fit the lyrics so well. I absolutely loved it because you got that sense of that, you know, like the old time musician, you know, Johnny Cash or whoever, with those calloused old fingers. He's got his acoustic guitar. This is the real thing. This ain't no J-Lo. This ain't no Britney Spears. This ain't no even modern rock bands. No, no, no. This is the real thing. You better see it while you can. I love the idea of the song, and I absolutely loved it. Then they said they're going to rock it. They're going to rockify it for Have a Nice Day. I didn't know how I felt about that. But when I heard it, I said, that is freaking sick. And we still got both versions. Both versions are released. So if I'm in the mood for the slower, you know, that version, which I think fit the lyrics a little better than the version on Have a Nice Day, but this version just rocks. It's just a kick-ass rock song. He opened the show with it that year, and in 2006, and during the tour, it was absolutely awesome, and I just came to absolutely love both versions. This one doesn't have quite the feel of the other one, but It except for that, just by being an awesome song with an amazing riff, Richie's riff here, opening riff that he came up with, and it's absolutely awesome. And the chorus, the catchiness of the chorus is on display even more when you have the fast song, the rocking song. So then it has that hook, grabs you even more so than it does in the other version. So both versions just complement each other. They're so awesome, just whichever you're in the mood for. I think they're both 10s, and so I'm giving this one, Last Man Standing, the rock version, the Have a Nice Day version, an absolute 10. I absolutely love it.
The church, through the fields, in the dirt, in the dark, I have seen that the sun.
Next up is Bells of Freedom. This is the song of all Bon Jovi songs. You ask me, what's the Bon Jovi song you love more than any that's been released? It's actually on an album. I'm not talking about unreleased because I'd probably pick many of those. What's the one song you love that you absolutely love? It's one of your favorite Bon Jovi songs that really nobody talks about. Nobody really thinks about. They don't play it live. It's just kind of hidden on an album somewhere. It might be this one. Bells of Freedom, I loved since the first listen. Up till now, I think it's almost a perfect song. The verses especially, and the bells in the background to start the song, but the verses have just somehow, I don't know how he does it, but yeah, John Bon Jovi is able to come up with, and with help from, you know, his other songwriters, but come up with some awesome verses. The chorus of this song is also kick-ass. Just overall, I absolutely love Bells of Freedom. I love how it segues back into the second verse and all the instrumentals in this song and just comes together. It's just a fantastic song. I don't know if there's anything that just I can say about it that's special, you know, other than it just has the it factor for me. It just comes together and I love listening to it. And it's just a beautiful song. Great lyrics. Lyrics matter. When you're hearing a song, you hear some weird lyrics or some in your face or some on the nose lyrics. It's just like, cringe lyrics. I don't like that. This one doesn't have it. Yeah, though this song is just awesome. I love Bells of Freedom. Great, great song. And I actually, for me personally, it's one of my favorites, and I'm giving it a 10.
You serious?
When she laughs, she wants to cry. She draw a crowd and try to hide. Don't know if it's her or just my mind. I'm losing.
Next up, Wildflower. This one kind of has a feel for, if you remember Crush, there's a couple songs, She's a Mystery and Mystery Train. We're talking about this girl who's kind of different. Here he tries again, and I like this one better than any of them. This is a great song, Wildflower. It just, this one hit. This is the one for me that works. I think he was trying to work with that topic and trying to make something work. And obviously he liked those other two enough to put it on Crush, but I like this one even more. This is a fantastic song. Love the bridge on it, and it's got a short guitar solo. Wish the solo was a little bit longer. That's one complaint. But I love the verses. I love the sense of going into a pre-chorus just naturally when it has a sense of speeding up, and then it hits that chorus. Nobody knows. Again, it's not one of my favorites on the album. It's actually, you know, but I'm going to give it an 8.5. But when you're dropping in quality and you still get an 8.5, that just tells you how great this album is. This album's not slowing down. So it is just a fantastic album, and it's a great song. I really like Wildflower. Don't like it as much as some of the other songs on here, but I'm still giving it a really nice score of an 8.5, so that's Wildflower.
You always lose the girl in a Brian Wilson world. One less cigarette, savor it, take it in and hold your breath, hope it never ends, and when it's gone, it's gone. One last cigarette, last cigarette, I will savor it, the last cigarette, take it in and hold your breath, hope.
Last Cigarette, this one really impressed me. First time I heard it, I said, you know what? They're working hard. I love it when they work hard. This is supposed to be the hardest working band in the world. Come on. I'm not saying they don't work hard. Of course they do on every album, but I feel like what happened to the days of, you know, Keep the Faith, Dry County, Keep the Faith Itself, all these songs that you can tell, man, they worked their ass off on those songs to really make them hit quality on every level and just amazing stuff that goes on during these songs instead of just, you know, strumming along or something. And that's why I love Bon Jovi. This one, they worked hard on. This one, especially some of the way the background vocals work, the way it goes into that bridge, that Beach Boys style bridge, and everything else about it. Just a really fun song. This one just kicks ass. I can tell that they spent some time on this one. And Last Cigarette, great production. Just a really fun song, great chorus, great bridge in this one. A lot going for this one. Last Cigarette, first time I heard it, I said, wow, I love that one. I thought it might eventually, you know, get up there. Never really got up there to the 10 level, but it is a great song. I continuously enjoy listening to Last Cigarette. Man, this album's even better than I remember it. There's so many great songs. But Last Cigarette, great song. I'm giving it a 9.5.
In your last book, can't buy a lucky break. If all we've got is us, the life's worth living. And if you're in, you know I'm in. I'm ready and I'm willing. I am. When you think that no one needs you, sees you or believes you, no one's there to understand. I am.
Ton of 9.5s on this album. That's rare. That's rare. That's no disrespect. That's actually awesome that so many songs are right there at 10 or just below 10. And I Am is another one. Great song. Love this song. Love the beat going into the song, the guitar riff and the drums and everything going into the verses here. The verses just have that it factor in this one. And a really cool sound overall. And then a great chorus and a catchy chorus. Now, there is a song I'm going to talk about towards the end of this review that didn't make the album, and I hear that it didn't make the album because it sounds similar to I Am, and I do hear that similarity. I like the song that didn't make the album even more. That song is going to be a 10. This song, it's awesome. I love I Am. I wish they would have kept both songs on there. Like I just talked about earlier, you had She's a Mystery and Mystery Train both on Crush. You have songs that are similar on the same album. If they're great, they're great. Put them both. That's my personal recommendation, but it is what it is. One album, one song didn't make it. This one did, and I Am is fantastic. I love I Am. I wish they played it more live. I think they only played it one time, even on the Have a Nice Day tour. So for whatever reason, you know, there's certain songs that they just won't play, and whatever. I Am is great. I love it. I love the chorus. I am when you think that no one needs you. It has a sick guitar solo. The guitar solo on I Am, that's some pure Richie right there. He actually had some time to do something and really kicked it out with some palm muting, some technique there, and just a great guitar solo by Richie Sambora in I Am. And it's just a fantastic song. I love I Am, and this one's also getting a 9.5.
Yeah, sweat. What you get ain't what you see. Up is down and black looks white to me. I'm complicated, I get frustrated. Right or wrong, love or hate it. I'm complicated, you can't sedate it. I heard that song, but I won't play it. It's alright, it's okay.
Up next is Complicated, and this song has a complicated relationship with Bon Jovi fans, and I know this. Again, I talk to a lot of Bon Jovi fans, and I read a lot online how they feel in the forums and stuff, and I don't know why a lot of fans don't like this song. They just don't care for it. I don't know what the heck is going on because I love this song, Complicated. When I first heard it, I said, that's my favorite song on the album. And I can't even say that I've changed that opinion. I love this song. It has got hooks everywhere, verses, great guitar stuff going on here with the way the guitar stops, the drums, and John comes in and then boom, it hits with some hard stuff right there and then stops. Fantastic chorus. Just an amazing hook. It's just infectious. I guess a lot of Bon Jovi fans, obviously not infectious to them. They must have the vaccine. I didn't get the vaccine for this song, so it got me hard. I love Complicated. I think it's just a great song. And then I love how the bridge hits. Pretty much everything stops. Doesn't overdo it, but occasionally there'll be a Bon Jovi song where everything just stops for the bridge. It has that halftime feel. It's really sick. It really works in this song, in my opinion. And then it comes back into that chorus again. Just Hook City with this song. I really do like it. It's just me personally. For me personally, this song is my favorite on the album, and I'm giving it a 10. Sorry. Next up, we got the first disappointment, shall we say, with Novocaine. I definitely needed me some Novocaine after I heard this song, and this song was a disappointment first time I heard it. Listened to it a few more. Did it grow on me at all? Slightly saw some stuff I liked about it here and there. Interesting sound, but no, I never really liked this song. And unfortunately, they did play it live at the show I went to, which there's a reason I kind of did enjoy it. I'm about to talk about the thing I do like about this song. It's a very small thing, but overall, this song never really grabbed me. I didn't really enjoy the verses. Don't really enjoy the chorus, the lyrics for the most part, kind of interesting, but you know, talking about Dr. Phil in here, it's pretty weird. It's just a weird song. I just never really liked Novocaine. I can't lie about that. I just never really liked it. The only part I like is during the second verse. I love how the background vocals come in to highlight, you know, the points of the lyrics a little bit with their own lyrics. It's really cool. I like how, you know, you took my favorite belongings. Let's get this straight. I like that part. My favorite sweats from high school. Tried to sell my muscle cars. That's not okay. That's the only part of the song I like. I really do like that part. The background vocals there. And then I liked it live when they're like, that's not okay. Your mother's gonna visit for a couple months this year. I mean, it's decent. You know, the verses got a little bit of little hook there. But the chorus just kind of just didn't do it for me. And I can see where people could like the song. I can see that, but just didn't, my ears personally, it didn't hook like the other songs did. But I'm not saying it's the worst Bon Jovi song, but definitely not good for me, not at all. So I'm going to give it, unfortunately, a pretty low score of a 5. I'm going to write the melody that's going to make history. But luckily, things recover to end the album with Story of My Life. And I love this song. And I love the piano intro there. And it sounds like you're going to get something a little ballady, a little quiet, a little, you know, no. Bam! Then it rocks. And the great bass line and everything goes on there. And then how it stops, comes in with the lyrics. And I love the lyrics of this song. And it kind of reminds me of John and Richie and their relationship here, especially coming into the second verse. When I write my masterpiece, I'll show you the chords first. Something like that. And just a great song and a very kick-ass song and a great way to end the album. I love how it ends the album. And a fun chorus and great guitar work, great guitar solo on this one as well. It's short. It's a little short for my taste, as most guitar solos have been, at least post these days, you know, the modern stuff, the 2000 stuff. Guitar solos kind of not like they used to be. But you know what? This one's really cool and a great job overall for this song. I really enjoy it. It's not one of my favorites on the album, but it's a really great song. Story of My Life. I'm going to give a very solid 8.5 to it. As you can see, it's a great album. I do want to at least mention some of the tracks that didn't make the regular American release, but were either unreleased songs or they were on some UK or the Japanese. This right here I bought in Mexico, and it actually has Dirty Little Secret on it, which is an amazing song. And I was just blown away when I heard that song. I was like, how is that not one of the main 12? Whatever, it's an awesome song. It's an absolute 10. And pretty much there's nothing but 10s when we talk about songs that didn't make Have a Nice Day. Another one is Nothing, and that's the song that sounds like I Am, except it's even better. Nothing is incredible. Guys, if you haven't haven't heard it, look it up on YouTube. Listen to it. It's called Nothing. It is an incredible song. It's an absolute 10. It should have been on the album 100%. A third one is called Unbreakable. And what a cool song that is. I can understand why they didn't put that on there because it's a little different. But it is awesome. Unbreakable rocks. That one's close to a 10, maybe a 9.5, but man, what a song. And then there's a fourth one that's more of a ballad that they gave to Clay Aiken. It's called These Open Arms. Took me a few listens, but that one also really grew on me. That one I love a lot. And it kind of reminds me in some ways of the new song Love Can that they also threw off the album, made it a bonus track or something. So what can you say? A lot of great songs just left off albums. It's sad, but at least we can still hear them, you know, with the modern technology and stuff like that. So at least that. But at the end of the day, those all four of those are close to, if not 10s. So what can you say? Nevertheless, there's a lot of 9.5s and 10s that did make the album, so I'll give John credit there and the band. Great album. Have a Nice Day is absolutely epic, an awesome album. Overall, high points are the whole album. Low points, other than the low points, which really there's only one low point, and that's Novocaine. And I guess Welcome to Wherever You Are, for me, somewhat of a lower point. But other than that, this album just kicks. A great album right here. I'm going to give this album a great score, just dropping short of a 9. And that for a whole album to be a 9, that tells you how much I love this album. I'm giving it an 8.9 for Have a Nice Day. Fantastic album. One of the best. I saw them live during this tour and they kicked ass. This was Bon Jovi almost at their best. I think at their best maybe have been 10 years prior around the These Days era. I think that may have been their absolute peak. But right here, they're damn close. Damn close. This was a great album. Have a Nice Day. Love it. Tell me what you guys think about this album in the comment section down below and we will talk about it. But this was a great one. An absolutely rocking album. Have a Nice Day. Can't wait to talk about this when I do my ranking video. We'll see where it's at. It's going to be interesting, but obviously this one's going to be up there. So guys, thank you so much for joining me today. Let me know your thoughts down below. I look forward to the next review, which is going to be Bounce. We are going to bounce out of here for now until then. So I can't wait to talk about Bounce next time. So we'll talk to you then. See you later. It's a real thing.